Hello, everybody, and welcome to another review from the Broken Controller Club. As always, my name is Ed, and I'm your host. Before we get started, I want to shamelessly urge you to hit that like and subscribe button, as my mother didn't hug me enough as a child, and your support and that bottle of Everclear hidden in my filing cabinet are the only validation I get now. I'm just gonna come out and say that I'm not really a big shooter guy. I grew up playing the classic Apogee, 3D Realms, and ID Software shooters like Blakestone, Duke 3D, Shadow Warrior, and of course Doom, both old and new, and the old Wolfenstein 3D where your friends don't get their brains sucked out of their heads. Those are always going to be my favorite for being arcade-like experiences that didn't require much story, just fun action. They were the perfect fit for those of us whose idea of action movies star guys like Schwarzenegger, Ford, Stallone, Norris, or even Bruce Willis before he started hating every movie he filmed. So with all that being said, I really like the Plants vs. Zombies shooters. See, my favorite games don't always take themselves seriously. I like a game that's got great action, bright colors, and a good dose of humor that tricks me into thinking the developers had as much fun making it as I do playing it. I got the first Garden Warfare for free back when EA did their presentation at E3 and announced on stage that the game was free to download. It was a great idea because it got me hooked and I was a day one buyer for Garden Warfare 2, which did not disappoint at all. So picking up Battle for Neighborville's Founders Edition was easy for me, and for the most part, I'm really happy with it. Let's start with a quick synopsis of what this is about. You have the plants, led by Crazy Dave, to defeat the zombies, led by Dr. Zomboss. They fight for control of, well, everything. The world, the TV set, your mom, that saucy old harlot. It's the classic Hatfields versus McCoys feud, but with lots of foliage and rotting flesh. It's spy versus spy, with bean guns and goo blasters. You get the idea. It's one of the funnest and most original stalemates in gaming. So what's PopCap and EA done to bring you back this time around? Thankfully, a lot. As far as I can tell, the game's a few steps forward and one step back. Let's start with the steps forward first. There is a nice assortment of new characters this time around that play pretty differently from previous additions to the series. On the plant side, you've got the Acorn, the Snapdragon, and the Nightcap. For the zombies, you've got 80s Action Hero, Electric Slide, and Space Cadet. The Space Cadet and Acorn are able to combine with other players for added firepower. However, when one goes, they all go, so there's a risk in doing that if you want the added firepower. I've seen people do this in multiplayer, and the carnage these team-ups can do is pretty huge. The greatest variety in characters this time comes from the Nightcap and 80s Action Hero. Where the Nightcap can stealth for short periods of time and brings a sort of ninja element to the game, the 80s Action Hero uses crossbows to charge up his shots and has an evasion move that simultaneously drops dynamite. It's very effective, as I have been killed by it many times, because I'm awful. The new hub and main battleground is Giddy Park, and with it comes a ton of single-player content that expands on what was available in Garden Warfare 2. Where in that game you were able to fight it out in a single large area and take on quests in there, this time you can actually travel to different themed areas, two per side, and take on quests to further storylines in those areas. In addition to that, you're fighting NPCs, hunting down treasure chests, and earning gold and whatever the themed currency is in that area to purchase more vanity items or even just exchange them for gold. It's a great way to still have fun when you want to play but you're not in the mood for multiplayer just yet, or if you want to get used to playing with another character. There's also hunts or bounties in each area where you'll be tasked with defeating a particular enemy for a reward, and you'll randomly come across other enemies like the Treasure Yeti. There's a ton of fun surprises in store, and I'm taking a wild guess that PopCap will continue adding more over time. Giddy Park itself I found to be kind of boring. You can run around there and fight enemies from the other team, but then you're just limited to what's basically a team deathmatch with no timer or goal. The people online in your session will vary at any given time, so jumping down there usually means getting ambushed by multiple players or being outnumbered. So in that case, I just didn't see the point in playing there when I could play multiplayer instead for more rewards and an even match. Maybe that'll change, or maybe I missed something. Customization is different this time around. When you're picking a character, you're not just customizing their vanity items anymore, but also you get to choose their upgrades up to a certain slot limit. The fancier upgrades take up more slots, so you'll have to prioritize. Promoting characters is back from the last game, and with those promotions come newer upgrades as well. There's everything from getting boosts after reviving allies to faster reloading, or boosts to certain skills. Like to play different ways? Well, you're in luck because you've got a few loadouts you can save your choices to as well. Multiplayer is back and it's largely unchanged. You've got your Team Vanquish, Garden Ops, Turf Takeover, and one I really like called Rando Ops, where every time you die, you respawn as a different character. I thought this was a great way to try out different characters without having to make the decision myself. It's also a great way to get your butt kicked in if you don't know how to play with someone. Winning and losing matches gets you coins, and you use those coins at the Mr. Rewardotron 9000 for emotes and costume items. I personally think the price is a little steep at 30,000 coins to use it, but then they also don't want players getting it within the first month the game is out either. So what's the step back I mentioned? So this is just a personal gripe, but I can't imagine I'm the only one who will feel this way. In Garden Warfare 2, some of the character skins included changes to weapons. So for example, my favorite zombie last time was the soldier, but my preferred costume was the centurion, and with that came a flaming crossbow that would do damage over time when I hit an enemy. The scientist's goo blaster was replaced with some other sort of gun. You get the idea. Anyways, in my experience playing, none of that is there this time, and the costume items are simply for vanity, and that's it. I was really disappointed to see that, because the added variety to weapons was really fun last time. Hopefully they'll get added back in later. So my verdict on this one. The game's got a ton to do, the new characters are great, the game is just as colorful and funny as ever, and the upgrade system brings an extra element of strategy to how you play. Also, this game doesn't have the usual stink of EA's microtransactions all over it, at least not yet. All of this is totally overshadowing my gripe about the lack of weapon customization and my boredom with Giddy Park. It's a great shooter that's not military themed or one of those battle royale clones out there. Go buy it and have fun. And that's all the news that's fit to print. Thanks again for watching, and remember to eat your vitamins and look both ways before crossing the street. Also, courtesy flush. I'm not gonna say who, but people have been talking. Ciao! Do you like what you see? Or did you lose a bet and have to subscribe to your most hated channel on YouTube? Do you feel sorry for me? Be sure to ding that sexy subscribe button before changing channels, as I have no shame, we'll take whatever I can get. Thanks again for watching.